Kobo Toolbox is the best data collection tool for open source and NGOs. So before starting this video, please see this video Docker setup and Docker Compose setup. So just start with your Ubuntu machine. So just navigate to your Ubuntu machine and go to terminal. So even it can be your virtual box, so Ubuntu machine, no problem. So just open the browser in Ubuntu machine and then search the Kobo install. So here you will find a GitHub link, so Kobo install. So just copy the install link and go to the terminal and write git clone and paste the your copied link. So the project will be downloaded in our home directory. So we will just use this project to set up. So if you see using ls, so ls will show the list of directory or files exist in your current directory, home. So see here Kobo install. So we will just access this directory by writing code cd kobo install. Okay, so if we just enter, then we will navigate to this directory. So then if we see the ls, see here a lot of files exist that we downloaded already from GitHub link using git clone. So now go to the GitHub and just copy this command from GitHub, Kobo install GitHub, and just paste this code inside the Kobo install. Already we navigate to the Kobo install directory, paste this and enter. So if you enter, you can see there is a lot of option will be showing for you, and you can just select any your expectation options. So here all the default option I will select, but here for advanced option I will just say yes, one. So if you just want to keep it as it is, you can just enter. So here we selected our workstation mean project will be installed in our local machine, not a server. So if we require to install it server, then we have to have at least four domain, one is for your main domain and another starting for using kf, another starting using kc, another starting will be ee. So now we'll just select all the default options, and if we require to change the options like super admin, we will put the admin as an admin user, and the password we will put the password as a password. Okay, so and then use developer mode, it's yes. Salary for background, yes. And then enter. Then if you just keep it, if you want to keep it as it is, then we can just enter. Debug option, we can make it yes or no, no problem. So we just make it default. So run npm, we will put it one, default. So Kobo PostgreSQL database, so database name will be as it is, I will keep it same. Just I will change the username and password for my remind. Okay, so you can use your own password and user. So do you want to tweak the PostgreSQL settings? Yes, and then it's giving error. So if error is coming for permission, actually we don't have any permission on this directory and for changing. So I will write sudo code like sudo chmod 666 /var/run/docker.sock, and if we just enter, then it will be permitted, but it's expecting a password mean our machine password. So the machine password, so I just given the password, and I'm starting the previous steps again, python run py, and I will select option. So I'm just selecting, you can just see my selection and you can just use your one. So here I'm just giving you the hints how you can use your domain. Okay, so this Kobo tool is very popular in NGOs, so you can use it in your own server by following these steps. So before starting this, you can see two videos at least. One is Docker installation, another is Docker Compose. So here I, for user and password, I provided admin and password, and all other things are same. So here a developer mode is 1, salary background is default, and our default Postgre database name will be as it is, because I will never change any database name, because I will change only the user and password name. So you can use admin as a user and password as a user, I mean password. Okay, so do you want to tweak Postgre settings? Yes, there was the error we get in this step, so but now it's not giving any error, because already we given the permission to this directory. So if you get any error during this tweak, so you can use the command that I shown you. So storage type, all the default option I will keep, and root user always be admin, and password will be password, and MongoDB user will be user, and admin user will be admin, and password will be password. For all password and user I use same for my testing, but you can use your own. So do you want to run the Redis container from the server? Yes, so I will keep default. So Redis password, so password I will always use password, so leave empty. For where I just getting any message, then I will leave it empty. Do you want to expose backend? This will be 1. I'm just giving 1, you can even use 2, no problem. Do you want to customize port? No. And all the default AWS 3, S3 analytics identifier, and do you want to additional settings, front end, back? These two options must be no. Okay, another one is front end, another is back end Docker container. Okay. So active backup, default, it's cloning the project. So working, so during this work you just remind, if you want to set up it in your domain, then you have to have for domain. So but for local you don't have anything, you just follow my steps. So here, do you want to review? Yes, I will review. See here already I get the links where I can access, but this will not be accessible until all the work done. So it's saying me to enter any keys, and yes, so still it's expecting another 600 seconds. So I'm giving that, and yes, it's done now, and we can see the link. Here is the link that we access from our Ubuntu local browser, I mean local machine browser. So if we just copy this link and we paste this link in our browser, this will appear, I mean application will appear. We will use this username and password as a credential. Okay, so I'm just copying the link to browser in Ubuntu machine, whatever it is, VirtualBox or your machine, no problem. So yes, application, yes, see application is coming. So and application is working perfectly. So if we give the perfect username and password, application will work. So you can write, you can now after entering application, you can just create your forms, you can just deploy your forms, and you can use this form for data collection as a data collection application.